Welcome to this week's episode of the Warlock's Brew. We are entering round three of Standard with Red Deck Wins. I'm the Maroon Warlock. Right now we are 1-1, and the magic gods of dice rolls like me today because we get choice of first or second to start game one for the third time in three games. So we're going to go first. This is a very keepable hand. We got our Flame Blade, we got an Incendiary Flow turn two, and then a Fiery Temper turn three if we really want to cast it for three. Hopefully we have another option to come up by then, but we got our turn one and our turn two. So far we've played against a green-black Constrictor deck, and we've played against a white-blue control Gideon and Gisela combo wombo-ness. So we're going to start with the Flame Blade Adept, our favorite Jackal in Standard, or at least mine. I hope it's yours as well. And we're just going to pass the turn straight into whatever they're playing and try to figure out what they got. I'm guessing Mardu Vehicles or something of that nature. They're getting their clue, their raging clue. We're going to drop a mountain. We're going to Incendiary Flow because, again, we want to try to play this as close to the burn strategy as possible. And I don't really care for Thraven Inspector beyond that. Like, they can't block that. Okay, I think they realized it. That's fine. I'm trying to remember if Kieran's a 2, so I'm surprised Thraven's still in the deck. Scrap heap! It's funny because they still can't block. I'm going to play the Aether Hub. Not huge on the two straight land draws, but it happens. We're going to go in with the Jackal. Deal the one. Probably tempering the Scrounger unless they drop a black here. Or drop things that they can eat the black with. Yeah, we're gonna eat the Scrounger with a temper. Because I want to stay ahead in this race. I'll take dealing them one versus me dealing, or them dealing me one with the way this race is going. We're going to probably end up having to temper that. Although, the only one it really affects is creatures, because other than the Aether Hubs, I don't have too many non-basic lands. We just get Hazoret, which is nice. I'd love to see more of Hazoret, though. We're going to drop Hazoret now. It's going to come in tapped, but regardless, it wasn't attacking till next turn anyway, because of if I attack with Hazoret here versus play it here versus later, no matter what, it wasn't hitting until next turn. And what's nice about this is that we can actually activate Hazoret's ability to discard, get the temper, blow up the Cathar, or Thalia rather, and then go from there, or just go ham in some other direction. They got their Gideon. Probably spawning a dude. They're spawning a dude guy. He's gonna need an answer. Probably redirect. Redirect the things. Alright, so we're gonna start with the little mountain. So that's gotta happen. I'm trying to think how I want to line this up, because that Tormenting's tempting to draw the cards, but I don't know if I want to draw cards. I think I just do it this way. Discard the Temper. Put that on the stack. Alright, so that 2's going to get redirected to Gideon. He's going to get a plus 1, plus 0. Temper's going to blow up the Cathar, because I don't want to deal with Thalia anymore. Yeah, we're gonna hit Thalia in the face. He's going to get bigger. We're going to redirect that to Gideon. We're going to move to combat. We're going to attack both at Gideon. Because that way, we guarantee Gideon goes bye-bye. So Gideon's gone. And now, that Tormenting can either draw me cards, or it gets fed into Hazoret. Probably going to draw me cards. Don't know if they attack here, because we got a 5. Oh, they're gonna go for the 2. That's fine, I'll take the 2. I'll take that 2 every day of the week. So we're going to actually activate here. Discard the Tormenting. Get that effect. It's going to deal 2. We're going to drop our favorite Minotaur right now in Standard, because there's really no Minotaurs in Standard other than him and, like, 2 others. No discards, because there's nothing there. And now we're just going to wreck face, because we're now Hellbent, which was my favorite ability during the original Ravnica. They're going to go for something. Don't know what. That's rough. That's rough, because I already know what's going to happen. I think. Not what I would have done. So what caused it to flip? I would have probably chumped Hazoret with the Thraben and put... Oh, never mind, because Menace. I'm stupid. I'm stupid sometimes, too. It's great. We're going to take that 4 at the face, because we don't have a choice. This looks more like a white red aggro. They're missing the black, though. Oh, never mind. Spire. Got it. Making their token. That's fine. Do we go straight at them? I think we just go straight at them here. I'm gonna go for broke and go straight for the attack. Straight for the kill shot. I might be getting a bit aggressive, and that's where it happens. Brawler dies, that's fine. Because that blocking order matters. So, we're going to activate. Discard Tormenting. Get those triggers out there. She actually loses vigilance. It's funny. Okay. I don't really care about the Gideon right now, so we're gonna let that just hit him in the face. Six, seven, eight. My count has 10. Oh, that's right. He's gonna get me on the Gideon. I goofed. And also the flip trigger. I'll make sure he sees it before I concede, but they got it. Or she, because there's a Linda there, so I'm assuming. I'm gonna make the safe assumption. Yeah, I'm dead. That is super dead. So we're gonna concede that. Go to Sidbird. Go to the Sidbird. I'm assuming there's vehicles, but I didn't see any. So I'm honestly like hesitant to actually put that in, because I might just be making a very general assumption. I do kind of want the Sweltering Suns because of token flood. So what I will do is I'll put in the sweltering suns. We'll take out a pair of the. We'll take out the harness lightnings. Lightning axe, take out two of the shocks. We're gonna go a bit more defensive here. Again, I'm kind of going off the fact I really didn't see much for artifacts beyond the one clue and the scrap heap. So, we're going to see how that goes. Hopefully this will win us a game and give us more information to evaluate game three. We're going to go first. We're going to keep this. We got the shock and do a brawler or a tormenting. I don't like two lands, but I'm willing to risk it. So we're going to start with a red and just do a quick pass of the turn. If they drop the Thraben, I might just... Yep, I'm just going to bolt the Thraben, the shock. I can't speak. We're going to do that. Just get it out of here. Be proactive. Play the Brawler, discard Tormenting. I like drawing cards, but right now it looks like the curve's looking pretty nice. I don't know if I need the extra draw. They got a black source. They got another inspector. That's a little annoying, but it happens. I got a mountain. We're going to drop the Helion. No. We're just going to go wide. Or big. I don't know if that would be really wide. They just let that happen. That's cool. I will pay the two. Scrounger? That's a sad day. So we're going to let them know. That's a sad day. Frowny face. All that. All that jazz. That was not what I wanted in life. Play the mound because they know one's there. Attack with both. See if they let it through. They'll probably block. Cool. They let me get that last hit in with the Helion. Helion dies. You will be missed. They can start doing the swing backs. They're going to just oath to our creature and opponent controls. That's rough. Oath is going to wreck our Minotaur. That's a rip for the ages. We're going to keep the one land in hand because there's no reason to play it. We're gonna punch Hazoret, or punch with Hazoret in the face. And unless they got a way to exile our 5/4 here, we got them on a two-turn clock. Or not quite two turns because shambling. Oh, that's rough. I don't have a way to deal with that. Hazard number two. Damn it. Flameblade Adept. Again, we still have them on a bit of a clock. It depends on if they start attacking with shambling. They kind of have to, though, so they might. They're not, because they just cracked for the clue. That was a bad play on their part, in my opinion, but they obviously are hurting for cards. They're going to play Thalia. That's fine. Honestly, it comes down to, do I draw Burn Spell now? We're going to play the Flame Blade. And we're just going to start attacking in there. The lower I have them, the better. So at this point, it's, do I top into a Burn Spell? I top into a Burn Spell, it's over. If I don't, we still got some shenanigans to go through. They're going to play Gideon, or not. Does he gain life? He does. I don't like that. So this is not vehicles. This is just Mardu Planeswalkers? So I don't... Okay, just want to make sure what she did. Yeah, they're going to stabilize a little bit here. That was not what I wanted. I gotta just keep the aggro up here. I prefer if you plus one'd, but you might. Yeah. Mountain. I'm okay with that. Let's see if they start doing shambling. Those are shambling lands. They're playing Gideon. This is gonna hurt my face. Gonna hurt the booty. Thalia. Okay, they learned. They're learning. Bright side, they have to block with both. Do that to make sure. There we go. Make sure that the knight at least gets killed. That's rough. Yeah, they're gonna stabilize. That cast out was perfectly timed. Oath of Lily. Is that the one that makes you sack things? Or is it spawn a zombie? I can't remember. Sack when it ETBs and then zombie. Every time after. Okay. Oh, he's plussing Gideon. I'm taking 5 to the face. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's rough. We're gonna stop. We're gonna cycle. Try for something here. Hail Marys. We're just gonna do that and die. It happens. We just didn't get there. We got close. We got within, what, 2? I'm just doing this for spite. And we're just gonna concede. GG's. It was rough. It happens. The only part of the problem with red is that that cast out can be rough, or enchantments can be rough because we don't have a way to deal with them. So that's it for this round. We lost 0-2 sadly, but we almost got there. They managed to stabilize all the lands and they hit the cast out at the right time. It happens. Got in the phase with Gideon and Sorin. Was kind of a surprise. So we're just gonna go with that. Join me for round 4, hopefully right after this. Again, should be in a playlist. If I made any really stupid misplays, let me know in the comments, whatever, because I'm bad at standard and bad at aggro, but we'll see how it goes, or we'll see where it goes. And I'm Warlock. This is the Warlock's Brew for this week. I hope you're enjoying so far. Hope to see you in the next videos.